And now we'd like to welcome Tim from the Rochester Museum and Science Center to the show. Hi, Tim.
Hey, gang. How are you doing? Good to see you again.
And Tim, what did you bring us today?
We brought you Portis.
Portis?
Portis the tortoise. He's a Russian tortoise.
Okay.
Now, it's not our name. It was donated to the museum.
Okay.
And the little boy that owned him named him Portis, so we didn't want to confuse him. We just kept the name.
Would he really be confused?
Well, he'd get over pretty quickly.
Right. So what's the difference between a tortoise and a turtle?
A tortoise will spend most of its life outside of the water, on land, whereas a turtle will stay inside. And this one, actually, this guy is a little bit different than all the other tortoises and turtles in that one of his names also is a four-toed tortoise, and most tortoises and turtles have five toes, so he's even more unique.
Cool.
Oh, wow. Now, where can this animal be found in the wild, and what type of climate do they live in?
Well, he's a Russian tortoise, so...
Russia?
Well, actually, Scandinavia.
Okay. Oh.
Denmark.
Okay.
No, just kidding. He's in, actually, the southeast part of Russia. You'll find him in Pakistan, Iran, and Afghanistan, mostly in arid and up in rocky mountain areas. Over 5,000 feet, usually, is where he likes to hang out.
Wow.
He likes to be in arid climates, but he's not really keen on the heat. Once it gets over 80, 85 degrees, he starts to dislike it, and then he'll go and he'll hide away.
Cool.
But he'll also live around streams. You have to keep his substrate pretty dry because that's better for his shell and his skin.
Okay. Okay.
But he still needs to get to where vegetation is and water.
All right, cool. Is the tortoise able to burrow?
Actually, they burrow very well,
cool.
But he has to burrow in the springtime because that's when the rains have made it pretty soft.
Right.
He'll go down probably a foot or two, and they'll do 2 or 3, 4 feet long, and then they'll have a big area where he can turn around, kind of like his own private cul-de-sac.
Sure.
So he'll hang out and burrow, but they actually share burrows every once in a while. He'll go across and go into somebody else's burrow, and they'll go,
thought I was home.
sorry, but I'm just going to hang out for a little bit.
Right.
And actually, when they hibernate, they can go down as deep as 6 feet, 2 meters or so, six feet.
Oh, wow.
Just to get away from the cold.
All right, now is he full grown or will they?
He's pretty close to full grown.
Okay, so that's about how large they get.
It's like a pocket.
Just about 5 inches. The males will be 5 or 6 inches. The females maybe just a little bit longer. But he's pretty full grown, although it's hard to tell. They live like 40 years.
Wow.
So it's.
That's a long time.
Kind of a guess.
It is. So do these guys have any predators?
Actually, they do, especially when they're younger.
Mm.
When they're younger, their shells are a little softer, and they're juveniles, they'll be picked up by ravens or foxes, or you can get, even, it depends on the lizards that are around in the arid climate, and of course, coyotes and things like that. But their biggest problem actually is just man, because they're losing so much of their habitat. So that's where
they've seen that with other things that you guys have brought in as well.
Exactly. Most animals will have that problem.
Cool.
Now, Tim, we'd like to thank you for coming in.
Oh, sure.
And if you would like to learn more about the Rochester Museum and Science Center and see other videos about animals, visit our website, homeworkhotline.org. And now, stay right there. We'll be back in a second. Bye.